Hello everyone. Well, today we are going to study about the larder, le garde manger. Garde in French means to keep and manger means to eat. So garde manger literally means kept cold to be eaten. Well, under this chapter we'll be first covering about the introduction of larder. Then I will explain you about the different equipments, both heavyweight and lightweight equipments that are used in the larder. Then we'll be studying about the different terms which are commonly used in larder. And then finally, we'll be studying about the duties and responsibilities of the larder chef. Well, from this chapter, every year we find that one question always comes in the exam which carries 10 marks. So if you watch this video carefully, you can easily score 10 marks as I'm going to cover the entire chapter in this video. I'll be covering the important section which generally are asked in the exam. So we are going to start. First of all, if anybody asks you, tell me the definition of larder. So how you will define it? Well, larder is a department set aside for the storage of all perishable food, both raw and cooked, and is also used for processing and preparation of all cold items served inside the hotel. Well, all cold dishes in the menu, such as hors-d'oeuvre, cold fish, salad dressing, are prepared inside the larder section. And garde manger is a French term which means cold kitchen and also termed as larder kitchen. Now this section is separate from the main kitchen and it is located in a cold place. And it should be close to the kitchen to avoid undue traffic and time wastage, as most of the food will be supplied from here. So it should be close to the kitchen so that we can save the time. And this section must be well littered and well ventilated, and enough space must be there for to store as well as to move around inside the section. And it must be able to store prepared food and buffet in a cool and hygienic manner. And the section must have all the sufficient equipments, both heavyweight and lightweight, and all the necessary fittings, plant, machinery, tools in according to the volume of business. Well, actually, under larder, the work is generally broken into various sections because this department carries out so much work, so it is impossible to do all the work from one section. So we divide this larder into four sections. One is appetizer section, second one is salad and dressing section, then there is butchery section, and then we have cold buffet section. Well, in the butchery section, all the cuttings of meat, poultry, fish, etc. is done. In appetizer section, we make all the soups, dressing, garnishes, and different types of cold snacks are prepared in this section. In under salad section, different types of salad dressings are prepared, such as mayonnaise, then vinaigrette dressing, French dressing, American dressing. Then different cold salads are prepared in this section too. And then cold buffet, Sommer's guest board, that is Scandinavian buffet, and all the cold dishes of that buffet are prepared inside this section. Now, workflow in the larder kitchen. Well, work is broken into various fields such as salad, poultry, cold buffet, hors-d'oeuvres, mousses, cold cuts, sandwiches, etc. Well, there is so much workload in this section. So, as I said earlier, it is impossible to do the work from one section. So, the work is divided into various sections. The butcher receives direction from the larder chef, and the butchery prepares various joints in advance, and that is done according to the menu requirements. Well, each day certain quantities of meat are trimmed to the first stage, and then it is supplied to the large kitchen. The larder section includes fishmonger, who will trim and prepare the dish ready for service and delivery. Well, not only fish, there is poulterer, there is butcherer, as the most of the cutting is done in this section. Cutting and then storing in the proper way is done inside this section. Different poultries are dressed, trussed and cut and supplied into the various section. Then there is a pork section also in this area where all the pork products and sausages are prepared. And chef de front controls the cold buffet section where he prepares all the cold dishes. And salads are prepared and assembled in this section. Hors d'oeuvres are also made and trolley is replenished by the chef hors d'oeuvres. Well, there are different types of adobes and appetizers, salad, everything is prepared inside this section. Now to make so many dishes, so many preparation, and to do so much cutting of meats and all, definitely there must be sufficient equipment so that the chef can store or can cut all the meat items and can prepare the dressing and etc. in this section. So these are the some equipments which we'll be studying in detail. There is hot plate, then there is a butcher block, then weighing scale is there, then we have refrigerator, industrial refrigerators are there, then brine meter is there, then mincer is there, then salamanders are there, then choppers, then we have so many other equipments are also used in the guard manger, such as buffalo chop, and then there is scooper, and there are different ladles, butcher block, slicer, blowtorch, pot pans, so many equipments are there. So we'll study them in detail now. Generally, there are various types of equipment that are used in ladder section, and we can categorize them into two headings. One is light duty equipments. Under light equipments, there are mixer, juicers, butcher blocks, storage bins, shelves, slicer, blowtorch, pot, pans, stock pots, frying and flat spoons. Then under heavy section, we have refrigerator, different types of walk-ins, reach-in, pull-outs, then food processor. So we'll discuss them in detail now. Then under heavy equipments, we have this equipment. One is the slicing machine, which is used for cutting slices of different cooked meat, such as ham or tongue or different poultry, chicken, meat, boneless meat. Everything is sliced by using this machine. And then mincing machine and food processor is also there. This mincer is used for mincing different raw meats and then processing. And then finally it is transferred to the various kitchen. Then there is electric grinding machine, which is used for grinding an edge of on knives and choppers or cleavers. It should be used if only the carbondrum stone fails to set an edge. Frequent use will wear the knives and the choppers down very fast. Then there are different weighing scales, light weighing scale, and there are graduated scales which are fitted with price chart showing the price at a glance. Well, there are different meat items which can be weighed and can be supplied to the various section from after weighing from this scale. Then there are butcher blocks which are used by butcher for jointing and cutting different types of meat. Then there is salamander, then grillers are there, toasters are there. They use radiation as the heat to brown the meat or for toasting bread, etc., which can be used for making different sandwiches, different canapes, and for it can be also used for grilling sausages. Then there is boiling plate, which are generally used to heat or cook different adobes or fat. Then also used for making aspic jelly, sauces, pickles, and there are many larder preparation which are made inside the larder. Now, one of the most heavy equipment in larder section is refrigerator. Well, most of the meat items are stored inside the refrigerator, and the temperature is between 2 to 5 degrees Celsius. Well, the meat is generally stored at minus 18 degrees Celsius, but after cutting of the joints and meats, the meat is kept inside the freezer, and from the refrigerator it is supplied to the various kitchen department. Well, as this refrigerator handles lot of meat, so you have to be careful that it must be thawed regularly. That means it must be defrost regularly to maintain the temperature, and the refrigerator must be cleaned, and the racks and bar must be removed and washed with warm water, and always the thermostat must be working, and there should not be any fluctuation in the temperature, and the temperature must be set between 2 to 5 degrees Celsius. As I said earlier, the cutting of meats are supplied from here directly to the kitchen, so we have to make sure that the bacteria are not infecting the kitchen. Then for keeping the whole meat or the whole chicken, then deep freezers are used. The temperature of these deep freezers is almost minus 17 to 18 degrees Celsius, and They help in prolonging the storage life of the perishables, as the meat can be stored here for around 1 month, 2 months. There are three types: built-in walk-in type, then deep freeze cabinets are there, then freezer cabinets are there. Then, as I said earlier, there are so many types of light equipments are also used inside the larder section. They are serving spoons and ladles, then sieves are there, colanders, conical strainers, then meat presses, pie mold, whisk, egg slicers, steel basins, graters, cutlet bat, trussing needles, larding needles. Then there are different types of blowtorch, pot, pans, stock pots, flat spoon, assorted knives, then butcher's choppers, filleting knife, palette knife, peelers, fancy cutters, wooden spoon, stick hammers, then decorating knives, vegetable scoops. There are so many equipments and the list is endless, because as I said, this section handles so much work that there are so many equipments that are used. Even assorted trays are also used for storage of food. Then brining syringe, brinometer, assorted thermometers. So many equipments, lightweight equipments are required to do the daily work. Now we have different saucepan and lids, which are generally of stainless steel or aluminium, and they can also be hard anodized, and they require utmost care for maintaining them clean. Then refuse bins are there, the waste bins, which are generally lined with disposal bags and which are emptied on daily basis. The bins must be stored in the air conditioned temperature, because lots of perishable wastes are handled, so there are chances that many bacteria, microorganisms, fungi, etc. can develop, which can deteriorate the food. Then there is lemon zesters, scoops, then butcher hooks, skewers, brinometers. Then this is the layout of larder kitchen. Well, as I said, this kitchen handles so much work, then there is a separate section for each type of work. You can see in the chart, there is poultry section, then there is a fish section separate, then there are three sinks, and then there is a section for refrigerator. That is the storing area, both deep storage and then refrigerator. Industrial refrigerator are used, which can handle more meat at one time. Then there are work benches. Then there is separate section for salad, where different types of salad dressings are prepared, like mayonnaise, vinaigrette dressing, then different types of fresh creams, etc., sour cream, etc., which are used for dressing fruit-based salads. Now there is also snacks counter, where different types of snacks are used. Well, as there is so much work that is done by this department, so this section must maintain a good relation with the other department, because if there is no good relation, then the other kitchen workflow may suffer. So because this larder or guard manger is a storage department for most of the perishable foods, and most of the foodstuffs are supplied from this section to the various kitchen, the function must be done in effective manner, and the department must operate with harmony with the other kitchen, as because they make all types of dressing and they make all types of meat cutting. So if there is no liaison, then the product may spoil, as they handle most of the perishable food. Beside that, the larder must be layout properly, and also savory fillings, such which are required by the pastry, leftover elements of any meal, and where the parts of meat or fish or egg, etc., will be transferred from the kitchen to the larder. So there must be a separate storage section where the leftover food can be stored at particular time. So that it has been seen, as I have already discussed, that this section handles so much thing that the chef guard the manger must be familiar with all the garnishes and accompaniments of all the dishes on the menu, in particular the classical fish dishes and entrees and soups. And close liaison therefore is essential, because various departments, if delays and complications are to be avoided, then if the service is to be avoided, the delay of service to be avoided, there must be a good liaison. So it is always advisable that the other chefs or other department chefs, they must make good relation with the larger section, because as this section handles most of the perishable food items, if the chef is not able to supply the food at the right time, then the food may spoil. So larder department generally coordinates with this following section, like main kitchen. Then they also coordinate with bakery and pastry, then pantry, coffee shop, and then restaurant. Then they wear the, they make different types of adobs, cold sauces, salads, cold buffet, dressings, etc. And gelatin products like aspic, mousses, mousseline, couli, chauffron sauces, cold soup, brines, cures, smoked products, galantine, pâté, sausages, terrines, etc. are supplied from larder to these kitchens. Now we'll be discussing about the function, section and hierarchy of the larder kitchen. Well, as there is so much work pressure, so definitely the hierarchy of a large hotel is very big. It depends upon the workload. If in small hotels the work is less, then the hierarchy may be small also. But in the modern catering business, the department has become as one of the most important department. As I said, it is dealing with all the most expensive food, meat, etc. So the business is directly affected by the food cost. So Chef Gad Manjar is the head of the department, who is assisted by various assistant chef, commis, trainees, then porters, etc. are there in this kitchen. Then larder section is responsible for preparation of adobs, appetizers, salads, entree, cocktails, then different cold buffet, then wedding buffet, conference, salad bars. So much work pressure is there. So definitely the hierarchy must be big so that the workflow is not affected. So hierarchy of larder kitchen, there is one executive chef. Then under him, there is one sous chef. Then we have one larder chef. Then CDPs are there, CDP under each section. Under boucherie there is one CDP, then under charcuterie there is one, then for handling chicken there is one, then for salad also there is a separate CDP, then for making adobs also there is separate CDP. Then there are three commis, commis 1, commis 2, commis 3, which work under CDP. Then these commis are assisted by the apprentice, as each commis will have one or two apprentice, and the under apprentice we have trainees who are the students from different catering colleges. And then under trainees they are porters who are responsible for cleaning equipments, heavyweight or lightweight, that are used inside the larder. Now there are, as the workload is so much, so definitely the Gad Manjar responsibility will be high. So these are the some of the responsibility of the Gad Manjar chef. He is responsible directly to the chef de cuisine, that is our executive chef. He is responsible for all the perishable and frozen food storage of the larder. He is responsible for all the cold foods that are issued from this larder. He is responsible for supplying different cuts, joint, etc., meat, fish, as required by other kitchens. Well, he is responsible for all the staff in the larder and their training. He is responsible for hygiene in the larder as per HACCP, that is Hazard Analytical Critical Control Point standards that you must have studied. He is responsible for maintaining larder control, like checking for quality and quantity, storing, keeping records of issue, daily stock sheet, etc. He is responsible for controlling pilferages, and his duty is to ensure that all goods received must be stored at the right place and the right temperature. And there are different sections in larder kitchen, and their responsibilities are also there. Butchery, they including the fishmongery and escalage, then marinated products. Different meat items are cut and marinated under this section. Then there is a separate section for salads, then for pickled products like the vegetables, fruit, fish, meat, which can be pickled. Then different types of brines, cures, and smoked products, there is a section. Then the cold soup and sauce also prepared inside the larder, so there is a separate section. As I have told about all these sections in the layout. And there is gelatin section. They make all a type of aspic, mousse, jellies, then coulis, chaufferon, etc. Then cold fish and meat, roasted, poached, then paste monte, where different types of carving, sculpture, dough, vegetable, fruit carving are prepared, which are used as the centerpiece for different types of wedding ceremony, etc. Then different types of cheeses, caviar, foie gras, etc. are prepared. And for making all garnishes for soup and for main course, etc., there is a separate section, and the chef must be familiar with all the important garnishes that are used in different dishes. And pantry section also is there, where they handle all the pantry orders. And this section has the responsibility of a la carte and buffet. There are various types of buffet, finger buffet, cold buffet, salad buffet, etc. are handled by this section. Well, in all, this larder section plays a very vital role. And without the larder, all the kitchens cannot operate smoothly, as this section not only stores the food, but also it supplies to all other departments. I hope I have made you understand about this chapter. We'll meet again in the next video. Thank you.